Hey, before we get into the video, if you want to earn some extra money just watching 2K, Madden, UFC, it don't matter, go to 1v1me.com. 1v1me.com is a website where you can bet on 2K wagers, Madden wagers, EA Sports, FIFA 24, Fall Guys, you name it, bro. You name it, bro. And if you sign up using my promo code Kirk, or with the link in the description, 1v1me.com/Kirk, you will get $10 when you make your first bet. Free $10 when you make your first bet. Even if you bet $1, $2, $3, it don't matter. They will give you $10 when you make your first bet, all right? Me, your Uncle H-Cape, I've earned over $1,000, $1,095 to be exact, betting on 1v1me in just 1 month. Over $1,000. And I don't even make that many bets a week. You feel me? Just yesterday, I earned $200 betting on three wagers. 2K wagers. I only bet on 2K stage wagers. But look, you want to go earn some extra money? Go to 1v1me.com, sign up using my promo code Kirk, or you can sign up with the link in the description. And they will give you $10 when you make your first bet, even if you bet a dollar on a 2K wager match. You feel me? And I'm creating a group chat. Creating a group chat where I drop all my picks for the days I'm making bets on. You feel me? Just go follow my 1v1me profile account called Homie Kirk. It'll be up on the screen. And I appreciate and love every single one of y'all. Let's get into the video.
Up the smoke, dominate choke. Ice, ice. My bro. Hey,
try to look inside the shadow. They tell the bitch that you f with the low, low.
What's good, my nieces and nephews of Homie Gang? Yo, Uncle is back again with another video today. And look, 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 you feel me? Today I got the most devious 6'8 meta point guard build for y'all on the NBA 2K24. You feel me? The 6'8 point guards are on 1v1me wagers. They're banned on 1v1me wagers because they deem them too OP. You feel me? But look, if you want to be devious, you like playing the park, stage, or whatever like that. You want to be a devious guard. You want to make guard be easier for you. It's always easier to use a 6'6 and above guard build. My favorite guard builds are 6'6 builds. I have a lot of 6'6 builds I posted on my page. But the 6'8 is easily one of the best too if you want to get super toxic and glitchy, because the height difference compared to the 6'6, the weight, the strength, and all that, you're going to be moving devious. 6'8s do have a disadvantage when it comes to speed, like on defense, but overall, a 6'8 is dangerous. And with this 6'8 build right here that I'm finna give y'all going to be moving different. Y'all going to be moving different. What I need for y'all to do is to like up the video, leave a comment, let your mama subscribe if you're new to the channel. I don't want to hold y'all up any more longer. It's time to get into how to make the meta 6'8 guard build on NBA 2K24. Let's get into it. All right, y'all, we are in the builder right now. What you want to do is, I love all my builds left-handed because, you know, I dribble on the right a lot. You know what I'm saying? They play my right. Whenever I shoot off my left hand. So if you dribble on the right a lot, you want to go with left hand. If you dribble on the left a lot, you want to go right hand. Feel me? Just so you can get less of a contest, on you. I go left hand, like all my shooting builds left-handed. Jersey number, I always pick jersey number 2. Y'all know in all my build videos, I say God is first, everything else is second in my life. We always got that number 2 on our back. You feel me? So jersey number 2, the position, we went point guard. You know what I'm saying? If we playing a 1v1 theater, it goes by position. Whatever position you put, that's what position they're going to match you against in matchmaking, all right? So if you go small forward, center, power forward, they're going to put you against a whole bunch of big post scorer motherfuckers, all right? Just go either point guard or shooting guard. You feel me? Point guard, shooting guard. Don't go small forward, power forward, because when you play 1v1, and matchmaking, they're not going to put you against point guards, and you're basically a point guard, okay? So 6'8", the weight, we went 202 pounds, and we went to a 6'10 wingspan. We went to a 6'10 wingspan, all right? Now, we're going to do the physicals first, and I'm going to tell you why I put everything in the physicals, why I did. All right, stamina, we went 99 stamina. Obviously, we are the primary ball handler, the main, the floor general, the guard. You want to have 99 stamina so you can dribble at maximum efficiency on the court, whatever, in whatever situation, twos, threes, or the ones. You feel me? Because you can use this build for twos, threes, and the ones. It don't matter. All around. It's all around ISO guard build. All right, 6'8", big body, just like last year. All right, you want to go 60 overall vert. I'm y'all gonna see why here in a second. you want to go 84 overall strength. 84 strength, I feel like, is like the minimum you should use for a big guard this year, 6'6 and above, because you get that bulldozer and a movable enforcer. A movable enforcer is basically your clamps this year. It helps you get body ups and stops in the paint from a lot of people that try to rim run. You know, rim run is still big in this game, especially with 6'6 and up builds. To help you stop the rim run, I'll tell you, the movable enforcer on silver feels like clamps on Hall of Fame. I'm telling you. You feel me? Just go a movable enforcer on silver. You're going to be good. And you're going to have bulldozers so you can bully anybody in the paint if you got to drive and finish and all that. All right. Acceleration, 73 overall acceleration. I'm telling you, when it comes to 6'6 and above builds, acceleration, you're not going to tell the difference, because you're not going to have the Kyrie Irving dribble style and you're not going to have the Steve Francis signature size up spam. So when it comes to 6'6 and above, acceleration does not matter really at all. And if you're not playing Pro-Am or anything like that for my smaller guard builds, you're really not going to tell the difference on with 73 or 77 acceleration on my 6'4 and belows. You can tell acceleration a little bit different when it comes to Pro-Am, because you know, dribbling a lot and all that. Acceleration just ties into your speed boosting moves, your first few moves, just a little bit. You feel me? But 2K Labs tested it. 2K2's tested it. They couldn't really find too much of a really difference with acceleration. But especially when it comes to 6'6 and above, because we don't have Kyrie Irving dribble style. And that's the fastest dribble style to speed up your dribble moves in the game. We don't got that, all right? For 6'6 and above. So if you're 6'6 and above, especially even being a 6'8, go 73 acceleration. This is only going to tie into your fast feet, getting blow by on silver and speed booster on silver. All right? 73 acceleration. Our speed, we went with 81 overall speed. You could go with 82 or 83, but we're just going to go with 81 for right now. We might make some tweaks to this. All right? We went with a 60 overall offensive rebound, because it's cheaper to get 60 overall offensive rebound and get cheap rebound chaser than it is to get 60 overall defensive rebound and no offensive rebound at all. Like I said, this build is for the twos, threes, and the ones court. So in the ones court, you are going to want to have offensive rebound, defensive rebound. And with the offensive rebound, if you're driving, most of these guards and all that don't have high offensive rebounds. So you're going to get your own board with being 6'8 and having 6'10 wingspan, rebound chaser, 60 overall offensive rebound. All right. Our block, we went with a 77 overall block. 77 overall block. This is going to get us chased down on bronze. And it's going to get us anchor, okay? Anchor real quick. Here, I haven't put our interior D right there, 61. Going to get us anchor. Anchor is very big this year. Pause. Anchor is very big, though. It gets you more body ups and better contests in the paint. I'm telling you, I have a 6'6 build with an 82 interior defense, and I don't get as much body ups and as much blocks and contests in the paint as I do with my builds with 61 interior defense and a 77 block. I'm telling you, I have an 82. Interior defense. Same block, 77 block. But I'm telling you, the chase downs and the blocks, not. I don't get them nearly as much as with bronze anchor. I do with this build with bronze anchor. Okay, bronze anchor is very big. Helps you get better blocks, better contest animations in the paint. You feel me? The defender might get more rim stuffs in the paint as well with anchor on bronze. So we want to go with anchor on bronze. 61 overall interior defense, tied in with the 77 block. All right. Perimeter defense. You want to go with an 85 overall perimeter defense. That's all I really feel like you need. Defense, you really wouldn't even need perimeter defense this year. I'm actually going to make a build with 75 perimeter defense and just have all these on like bronze. All my clamps bronze, ankle braces challenger, all those badges bronze. Because I feel like perimeter defense is a scam this year. Just like pass accuracy. Y'all know pass accuracy is a scam, bro. I'm telling you, pass accuracy is a scam this year. We went with 85 overall perimeter defense. This is a balanced out defensive build right here. The 91 steal is all right, but you can't even get 91 steal on a 6'8. So you're gonna get 85 steal with a silver glove is OP, but it's not worth it. I'm telling you, you really don't need it. Play D, play actual D. Don't be relying on spam steals, okay? Play actual defense, okay? Now, speed with ball, we went with a 75 overall speed with ball. This is going to get us all the good dribble moves. Speed with ball does not even matter this year, and it hasn't mattered for the past few years. Speed with ball doesn't make your player any faster or slower. It just unlocks you dribble animations, and all you need is 75 overall speed with ball to unlock all the best dribble animations in the game. All right, ball handle, we went with an 85 overall ball handling, so we can get all the good dribble moves, and we can get ankle breaker on gold. Our speed booster silver, handles for day silver, blow by silver, pluckable silver. I'm telling you, unpluckable silver and gold, there's no difference. You're gonna get ripped regardless if you stand still dribble, or if you stop dribbling in front of a defender or a guard that has 91 overall perimeter defense or 85 overall perimeter defense. I have builds with 90 90. I have 6'6 and above builds, 6'8, 6'6 and above builds with unpluckable gold, unpluckable silver. There's no difference. With 91 steel is so OP that you'll get ripped if you have Hall of Fame unpluckable. It doesn't matter. The only way to not get ripped from somebody with a 91 or steel or 85 steel or and above is keep running dribble, do dribble moves that keep you on the move, keep you running left and right, keep you running left and right where they cannot steal the ball from you. Okay, that's the only way to negate getting the ball stolen from you. Unpluckable, gold, silver, whatever it is, they're all the same. You're gonna get ripped. Okay, don't go ahead and wasting your badge points thinking you need unpluckable on gold. It don't matter. You're gonna get ripped if they have a 91 steal and you stop dribbling, stand still dribble, or anything like that. All right, pass accuracy. Okay, this one is, we're gonna come back to this one, okay, because it's everybody's personal preference, but I went with a 77 pass accuracy just for the all-around aesthetic. Okay, the all-around for you playing the threes, the twos, and the one. Okay, go 77 pass accuracy. It gets you needle threader on bronze. So if you dot your corner man, if you're playing the threes, or if you dot one your popper when you're playing threes, and somebody's ball watching on the twos, threes, or whatever, they're gonna get stuck in mud animation. You've probably gotten that animation before when you're ball watching or you're baiting out the corner or baiting your defender going up and down on the paint, and the guard dots his spot up, and you feel you're trying to move back, but you get stuck in mud. That's because needle threader. Okay, needle threader gets you stuck in mud, or your defender stuck in mud if they're ball watching, or if they're not hugging the defender that they're on. Okay, and you get the John Murray passing style with a 75 overall pass accuracy. That's gonna be big for you, because John Murray passing style is one of the best passing styles in the game to speed up your passing for you. Okay, 3-point, we want an 86 3-point. This is all I really feel like you need when it comes to 3-point. You don't want to go with 86. You either go 86 or you go 92. You're not, there's no in between. Don't go 88, don't go 90, don't go 91. If you're gonna go 91, you might as well go 86, because the 3-point is gonna feel the same. Okay, especially because mid-range, our mid-range, we want a 90 mid-range to get our blinders. Look, mid-range gets you all these badges. Look, if you don't put mid-range, you don't get all these badges, and you go just to 86 3. You put mid-range at 90, oh not 94, I'm tripping. Put mid-range at 90, you get blinders, all of gold, catch and shoot gold, dead eye gold, green machine gold, space creator gold, guard up gold, midi magician gold, and you get open looks, Hall of Fame, and comeback kid Hall of Fame. Open looks is a very big badge to have. That on Hall of Fame is going to boost your green window, and it's going to tie into boosting your 3-point green window as well, with as well as green machine boost your 3-point window when you green two shots in a row, catch and shoot, blinders, and all that. Blinders on a 6'8 is big, because you know what I'm saying, 6'6 and above builds, 6'4 and above builds, they don't get contested as much as a 6'2, but the taller you are, the less the ghost contest is going to be, if that makes sense. Because ghost contests are real. When somebody's closing out on you, but they don't get a really actual good contest, but it's a ghost contest, and it still says open or wide open, but you can tell your shot sped up or slowed down, that's a ghost contest. All right? When you're, the taller you are, the less the ghost contest and the side contests are going to be. And especially with having blinders, it's going to be like, this is like having blinders Hall of Fame on a 6'2 guard. All right? Blinders gold on a 6'6 or 6'8. You feel me? So go 90 mid-range, 86-3. I'm telling you, when it comes to 3-point, you either want to go 86 or 92. There's no in-between. And if you go 92, you either want to go 92 or 96. There's no in-between. You don't want to go 93, 94, 92, or 96. You feel me? 86 or 92, all right? Your 3-point is going to feel exactly the same, Mom. I'm telling you. All right? And 90 overall mid-range is going to get us our Tracy McGrady jump shot, which is the best jump shot base in the game right now. So go with the 90 overall mid-range right there. All right, and then our driving layup, we went with an 87 overall driving layup. This is going to get us Fearless Finisher, Slithery Finisher, Acrobat, Aerial Wizard, Bunny on Gold, Pro Touch, very, very important badge. Scooper, very, very broken badge this year. Giant Slayer, Spin Cyclone, and Two-Step on Hall of Fame as well. And our driving dunk, we want a 75 overall driving dunk. I realize you only really need a 75 overall driving dunk for all the good dunks. You get all the good reverse dunks. You get DeMar DeRozan dunk. You get Giannis dunk. You get a whole bunch of just valid dunks that are just amazing. You get DeMar DeRozan dunk, and like I'm telling you, DeMar DeRozan layup, like I'm telling you, all you need is 75 overall driving dunk and you're gonna be solid. And then our standing dunk, we went with a 73 overall standing dunk to get us our fast switch and rise up. Fast switch is gonna speed up your standing dunks or your layups around the rim, and then rise up is gonna make it, you're gonna be able to basically posterize somebody while they're under the paint, like especially if you're going against a 6'6 or under build, yeah, you're gonna be able to posterize them easily while standing under the paint. okay? Go with 73 overall stand. Well, actually, we want 75. It's going to unlock more standing dunk animations for us. And you're going to basically have almost all the standing dunk animations in the game. All right? This is the best all-around 6'8 meta guard build for y'all. You got the finishing. You got the shooting. You still got the passing and dribbling, ball handling, dribbling. You have defense, and you have still the physicals. Like, you're going to have bulldozer tied in with your finishing. You're going to be a menace in the paint. And if they slag off to let you shoot because you're driving a lot, you could just shoot them over. You got a 90 mid-range, which is going to tie into your three-pointer. With those badges going to tie into your three-pointer, open up your green window. You'll be able to shoot good, and you're going to still be able to get all the good dribble moves with an 85 overall ball handle. All right. We're going to go through this right here, and we get shades of... Oh, I forgot even to tell y'all what y'all could do. Tyrese Halliburton, Katie Cunningham, and Austin Reeves, and you get three-level threat, all right? Three-level threat. But hold on, let me show y'all real quick some secret sauce. Listen, pass accuracy really does not matter. To some people, it does. To me and a lot of other people, it don't. Pass accuracy, your pass accuracy feels the same at 55 and compared to 75. Like, you might see a little speed up, but... You just got to pass the ball a little bit earlier. So if you're planning on using this build mainly for the ones and twos, you really don't need pass accuracy like that. Go 55, pass accuracy will be fine. And you could put it on your driving dunk. You can upgrade your mid-range, upgrade your speed, upgrade anything on defense, okay? You could do it to your personal preference. And if you don't like this build how it is already, like just like this, tweak it to your own liking. Tweak it to your play style. You feel me? You could take down the driving layup, put it to the 84. You still get Scooper and Pro Touch, all those badges. You just don't get Fearless Finisher on gold, and you could just put it somewhere else. You feel me? Like I said, tweak this build to your liking. Tweak this build right here to your liking, to your playstyle, okay? Everybody's build should not be the same. You should not copy your favorite YouTuber's build. You should take their build and revamp it. That's how I like to do all my build videos. Y'all take it and revamp it, okay? But hey, this is just a template for y'all. Y'all revamp it to your playstyle. If you'd like to drive and finish a lot more, take some of the shooting down, put it on finishing, all right? Anyways, appreciate and love reaching with y'all. Y'all like the video, leave a comment, play your mama, subscribe if you're new. Until tomorrow's upload, it's been your boy, everybody's favorite uncle on YouTube, everybody's favorite uncle in the 2K community, Uncle HK.